Praise the Lord, hallelujah. You there? Hallelujah.
Yes, I'm here.
Hallelujah. We're going to keep ourselves, your name, anonymous. But what I'm trying to tell you is like when you cough like this, while you're praying and doing this deliverance, that's mucus. It's something like a mucus come out of you. How does it look like?
It looks like clear, I don't even know how to do this. It's like thick, wide color.
Like a vomit.
Huh?
It looks like something like a dog vomit.
Yes.
That's spiritual. Whatever they put in your drink or whatever they gave you to drink has come up spiritually. It's come up. That's a part of your deliverance. So part of your deliverance is coming out. God is cleansing you spiritually. God is cleansing you spiritually and taking everything out. We can continue to pray. So how do you feel now?
I feel better. Because I'm like, I didn't know all this stuff was inside of me. The white, clear white stuff.
You can give, can you give a brief synopsis of your deliverance? How did we meet and stuff like that? Like a brief testimony.
We met through a dream. You say you dreamt me. I didn't even sleep like that. And then I was actually going to pay my bill, and then the Holy Spirit just told me to go to a shop. And then I was talking about, when I had my customer, we were talking about prophecies that, oh, God, I sent time to help you out, and all of a sudden you just walked in. And then you told me, when I was talking to you, you said, oh, I dreamt you. You were the person I dreamt the other day.
And I dreamt also who? Who was the other young lady in the dream?
You dreamt the girl, my enemy. You dreamt my enemy.
And you remember who I was trying to find out? Who was this person? I was asking the young man, what's his name, and Damien?
Yes. Yes. As soon as I came to meet you and him, Rick, you were talking about the girl with the mirror. She told me about the mirror like about a year ago. And then you came and you told me, oh, you were talking on the phone with David. You said that there's a one slim girl. She has this voice and she was saying, oh, I have a mirror. And in this mirror, I can see everything that you're doing. So when you said that and it came to my mind, I said, it just came to my memory that I had a friend that was telling me, oh, don't you know that some people can see you in three from mirrors? So, hello? So,
Amen. Amen.
That came to my mind. I said, that's the girl. Yeah, that's my friend. That's my enemy. You told me that's my enemy. She told you the same thing in the dream, in that you are the one that chased her out of my life. And she did, before I met you, she did disappear out of my life. Mm-hmm. Hello?
Amen to that. Amen to that. And can you give us a brief testimony of the things that all you was brought up? You're not going to mention your country. You was brought up in a family of Muslim. Can you explain not everything about your life in detail, but how God let you see miracles that happen when you visit different churches?
I mean, I want to say that I'm a witness of Christ coming from a background of a Muslim background. Part of my family is Muslim. So when Muslims, they don't believe that Jesus is the Son of God. But me, I believe that Jesus is the Son of God, because I was having doubt in the moment, but after I saw the miracles, I saw people waking up. Like, there was one lady at the church, she was completely gone, she was dead. And Pastor Palm came and prayed for the lady and said, you will not die in Jesus' name, you will not die, you will not die. The lady came back. And there was another occasion where I had a friend, he was handicapped for about 3 years. His leg couldn't use his leg or nothing. So one day he was really complaining to me all the time. So I called the pastor that I met. I said, Pastor, I have a friend that's going through so much right now. Can you please pray for him? So the pastor prayed for him, and then in 3 days, I think the next day he started walking. He couldn't even believe the miracle that was happening in his life. And I was really shocked, because he went everywhere for prayers and nobody could help him out.
Amen.
So finally he got his breakthrough through this lady. Yep.
Amen. He was used for surgery to cut off that leg.
Yeah, he had a surgery about a week before the pastor prayed for him. And the surgeon was about to cut his leg off, and he was about to be, handicapped for the rest of his life. But God delivered him and saved him through all his troubles. And right now he is doing wonderful. He's working. He's just living a normal life.
To God be all the glory and the honor. To him be the glory. To God be the glory.
I thank
you. Yes, no type of compliment. God uses people. He uses you if you are a servant and you are available. Even and we went to his church, and there was miracles on that day that you witnessed. But unfortunately, we forgot to tape it on video.
Yes, unfortunately, that was our mistake that we did. But I mean, I witnessed all the miracles. I've seen what God can do, and I right now I'm a believer in Christ Jesus. Yep.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
My sister in Christ, amen. Thank you, Jesus. And about them, the witness that you witnessed one of the pastor's wives getting deliverance. Testify to that? Yeah.
Yeah, I saw the pastor's wife getting delivered. And the pastor's wife actually, she had like a spiritual snake that was coming out of her, and everybody was shocked because we have never seen such thing. And the snake came out of her body, and she was dead for 5 minutes. And the pastor stopped praying for her and said, you will not die. Awake, 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 awake. And then we were all shocked because we were like, okay, this lady is gone. All of a sudden, her breath started coming back. And that was really a miracle that had happened, because that was really unbelievable, because I was really shocked to find out that, wow, that Jesus really did have power to wake up the dead, you know. So that was really a shocking moment coming from a Muslim background. Hello?
Amen, amen to that. Praise the Lord. To him we give all praise and honor. And about your deliverance, because when I met you, your voice was the voice of a 10-year-old girl. Could you explain the miracles that God has done and through the prayer line and through the ministry? It's a walking, talking ministry, because I don't have a building. I'm hopefully with this testimony, and people will start donating in order for me to acquire a building, a place for worship. Could you explain in a few of your words how God has delivered you from October of last year to now we are in February of 2013?
I mean, God has really been delivering me. My deliverance is like, it's not ordinary. It came in steps. The first surprise I had was, we were here praying, me and the pastor, we were praying on the phone. All of a sudden, my voice just changed, and it was just transformed into an adult whose voice. I was really shocked, you know, and amazed. I was like, wow, I didn't know I even had this wonderful voice. And the second thing, we were praying, and I had anointing oil, and the pastor asked me, oh, can you... Okay, start singing hallelujah and glory, glory. And I was singing, and I didn't even know I can sing. It was just so, like, shocking. And the third one that I had, this is today is, what today is it, Pastor Pam? Yeah, today was really a shocking moment.
Today's the 20th, today's the 20th, right?
Today's the 20th. It's like my third deliverance. Yes, the evil spirits are really leaving me. Like, I had coughed up, like, mucus and some other things that the spirits are just leaving me. So right now I feel really good that God is trying to bring me out from the power of darkness into his glory and into his light. So I'm really, like, open to all the new things that are about to happen in my life. I'm really joyful right now.
Amen, amen. It's good to see our younger sister here. She is being so blessed, and many others who I wish could call in and give their testimony. But hopefully we will get all of those testimonies together and on one day on video. And we just want you to know that the God is the same God yesterday and today and forevermore. That he is a healer, and that he can destroy every satanic covenant. He can destroy any satanic oath. You can say it in your word. He can destroy anything that you have done in the past, whether you were in a Wicca, voodoo, any type of bondage, mental bondage, being abused, sexually abused as children. God can deliver anybody, anytime, anywhere. And this is a big witness, because this young lady was born and raised as a Muslim in a Muslim nation. And thank God, you know, he has delivered her from all these different powers of darkness. And he's continually delivering her. And what I'm trying to say, Christians also need deliverance. Because many Christians are being delivered from sickness, from disease. Other than that, there was two women who had cancer in that same church, and one had surgery that night, and she was delivered from gallstones. One was from gallstones, and the other one, I think, was colon cancer. So God is still delivering and delivering people. And then we have Adele Mother that was deaf, and now she can hear now. And the doctors are even amazed, because they said she will never hear anymore. But thanks me to the blood of Jesus. Just want to let you know that Jesus is on the main line. And he's looking for few men and women who really, really want to serve him. Because we are at the end of the door. We are in the last generation. And we got to wake up those who are faithful in Christ. They're being deceived right now, and they need to wake up. It's called tough love. We got to love one another and show the world that we love the Lord and we love one another. Amen to that. My sister, I don't know if you're still online.
Yes, I am. I'm still online.
Yes, I know you're feeling good. And God is doing great things in your life. Hallelujah. Praise His holy name.
Amen, 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 amen,
amen. And I thank you for your testimony. I thank you for putting out the word out there. So put the devil to shame. Let the devil know that God is God and He reigns forevermore. And He's the greatest power. Over all powers, He's the greatest power. We give Him thanks and glory in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
You want to say a little prayer before we leave?
I want to say to all the YouTube viewers and viewers all over the world that Christ Jesus is the Son of God, and He is the only way through deliverance and through all your troubles is through the blood, because I am a witness of what God is doing in my life, and there's more miracles coming my way. And for anybody out there, don't give up. Keep pushing, keep trying, keep working hard, and keep seeking, and you will find what you need.
Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Thank you, Jesus. And say amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. My granddaughter, she's 18 months old. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, my sister. God bless you. Amen.
Amen. Amen.